Diamonds, may you have many, many years of happiness away from Roosevelt.
Hello, yes. I would just like to say that I am really, really sad to see Aida Dadian leave Theodore Roosevelt High School. She was my mentor when I first came to this school, and she was a wonderful, considerate, fantastic, bright light in my days of early insanity at Roosevelt High School. And what else can I say? Tepper we'll get to later. We're not doing Tepper yet. We have to have Tepper here to do Tepper. But I really appreciate Lynn and Roe coming along here also today. And Miss Flowerman is backing up the rear here. And other than that, things are looking really wild. You know, I mean, everybody's here. We have 100 people invited. We're expecting some dignitaries, myself included. People are at the bar already. Hors d'oeuvres are being served. And it was a hell of a ride getting here through every little traffic light on North Avenue. It took me a long time. Does anyone know the quick route out of here?
Yes.
Good. Miss Glassman will supply me with that, and we'll make copies for all of you. And for now, see me later. I'll be back. Thank you, and...
Hi, I'm here to wish Geri Tepper well on her retirement and her beautiful new house in Florida. We will miss her. She did our attendance beautifully. I don't think anyone can ever replace her. She's just a great, great guy. Thank you.
Life is wonderful after retirement, Aida. Don't be afraid. You will have a new, better life. Geri, the same for you.
Hi, have a very happy retirement. I hope to join you real soon. Bye.
We're waiting to hear how retirement is because we're coming to join you next year. And we wish you a happy retirement.
Hi, Aida. I know you for less time than Geri, but you've always been wonderful. Geri, I know since first grade. But we wish you everything wonderful because you both deserve it.
Miss Dadian and Miss Tepper, I want to wish you happy retirement, all the best, lots of happiness, and thank you very much for all the help that I've got during the years. We'll certainly miss you, your smile, your walk, your everything. You are going to be so missed, you wouldn't believe it, but I hope you'll come and see us. all the best. Lots of health, happiness, and all the joy in the world. Thank you.
My dear, dear friend, how can I really do now without you? Coming up on the fourth floor, that hug and that kiss that we had in a hurry. But when I look back at 30 years ago, how we both had such a wonderful, wonderful time. I'll never forget it. I talk about it all the time. You taught me so much, and I just love you. I love you. I will never, never forget your love that you had for me, and you still have. My children talk about you all the time, but this is life. Life goes on. You're going to be with your grandchildren and a lovely husband. Take a beautiful trip and just make it safe. Bye, darling.
Ms. Dadian, I love you very much, and I'm going to miss your beautiful smile. I didn't see you too often, but every time I saw you, you were a breath of sunshine. Your elegance, your graciousness, I love you, and I'm going to miss you so much. I wish you all the luck in the world, and have a great time on your retirement. Love you very much. Bye.
Okay, Aida. From the very first time that I met you, I knew that you were special. And I'm going to miss you so much. Just knowing that you're upstairs, like, really made my day special, even though I didn't see you often. You know, even though I didn't see you every day. You are very special, and I will cherish your friendship forever. I wish you a happy retirement, lots of health, and happiness. And Ms. Tepper, happy retirement. Good luck to you.
Ready? Aida and Geri, this drink is for you. It's been a long time. Geri, it seems as though every time I see you up till today, and I'm sure up till the very last day you're working, we'll discuss something that has to be fixed, rewritten, redistributed before you go. And I can't imagine that attendance is ever going to be the same without you. Aida, I think I still have to work off the kataif and baklava. 18 years of that, it takes its toll if you look at me, but everything was always great when you were in the program office. I'm very sad to see both of you go, but you know, as a couple of people here already told me who have retired, life begins when you walk out of Roosevelt, but not when you walk in. Cheers.
Okay, Geri and Aida, I wish you the best in your retirement, you lucky people. I know you've put in many years, and I only have a few more years to go, and I'm looking forward to that as well. And may you stay healthy, happy, enjoy. That's what retirement is all about, and I will hope to see you maybe in our retirement. Just to be with you or just say hello. I think retirement is great, and enjoy, and above all, stay healthy. Thank you. Take care.
Alrighty,
Congratulations,
and wow, you're retiring, going to Florida, and you're not supposed to hear this, you're supposed to stay, watch it later.
Talk a little louder, I don't hear you.
Talk a little bit in Arabic, maybe nobody will understand what I'm saying. What else I want to say? How long should I be talking for? As much as this is Richard, he's hiding. See, Richard, want to say hi?
Hi, how are you?
All right. This is Jody.
Hi. Okay.
And this is Marvin. This is Marvin.
Hi there.
You talking to your wife?
Lynn, it's been a pleasure. Thank you very much.
Congratulations.
And for my next song.
Only you.
Hi, Geri. I just wanted to wish you congratulations on your retirement. Take care. Lots of luck.
No, not yet, not yet.
Ready, go.
Okay, we're celebrating today, Miss who? Miss Tepper. Darien, at a retirement party, so we hope them enjoy the time and had good fun at Roosevelt, and we're gonna miss them, and I hope that they come back over to school. Bye.
Good luck, Geri and Aida. Hope you enjoy your retirement totally.
Just around that time.
But a lot of things happened to Pia, so it was kind of tough.
Yeah, that's what you mean by change.
My dear Geri and Aida, how can I say goodbye? As we say in Spanish, hasta luego. You will always be in my thoughts, as I know that I will be in yours. We have shared so much throughout the years that just thinking about it, I get emotional. So let me just say adios, hasta la vista, amigas.
Aida, we'd like to thank you for making us part of your very special evening. It's a lovely place, and we just wish you the best in everything that you do in the future, and we hope to be there with you for all of it.
Absolutely. We hope to enjoy the vacations together, Aida.
Congratulations.
Lots of luck and happiness.
Okay. Hello. How are you?
Hi, everybody. Remember me? I want to wish Aida the best. I know she's looking forward to her retirement, but I'm sure all of you are going to miss her. And Geri also. What are you going to do? Is she still attendance? Is she still attendance? Yes? Oh, what are you going to do without her then? Again, best of luck to the two of them. And I miss them all of the time that I was away. Bye.
Hi, Geri. Just wanted to tell you I wish you the best, and I'm very happy for you that you're going, although I'm sorry for me that you're going, because you've been wonderful, and I'm going to miss not seeing you at Roosevelt anymore when I come in there. But have a wonderful, wonderful retirement forever and ever.
Hello, Aida. This is Jean Marie wishing you congratulations on your retirement. I'm so happy for you. As you can see, I might be out of sight, but not out of mind. I love you so much, and we'll keep in touch, and I hope you have the best future. Bye.
Geri, Aida, I wouldn't miss it for the world. I'm sorry I wasn't there with you guys for your last year, but I'll see you in Florida, Geri. Take care.
Ready? Okay, Aida, now that you're going to be a grandmother, it is time for you to retire. You know that we all love you, we're going to miss you, and we'll remember all the time that we spent together in Roosevelt High School. Thank you. Bye. Good luck.
Hi, Aida. Congratulations. I'm going to miss you, but I know you're down the road. Hi, Geri. Bye, Geri. That's okay. Congratulations, Geri. Bye.
Aida, look at my slip. I'll miss your baklava and all your food.
Okay, I'm gonna miss what?
Her baklava and her food and her tabbouleh salad. And Geri, thanks for that wooden locker after 17 years. It was worth the wait. And the bingo games. That's it.
Okay.
I get a hug too?
Hello, Aida and Geri. Before I go into the pool and take a nice dip, I want to wish you all a wonderful retirement. Between the two of you, are we talking about 75 or 100 years, whatever it is, you're a great asset to school. We love you very much, and we wish you the best of retirement you can possibly have. Take care. Toodaloo.
Hi.
This is for Aida. Aida, I love you so much. I'm going to miss you. I'm going to miss talking about you with Paula. I'm going to miss your presence, the funny things you say, just the way you would welcome students into the classroom and welcome my students and welcome me when I wanted to refresh my ESL techniques. I love you. You're just going to have a really wonderful life. Enjoy the grandchildren. And for Geri, thank you so much for being a leader in our department. And I'm going to miss you too. But I wish you a happy retirement.
Congratulations. I'm sorry I don't have a voice. I hope you understand what I'm saying. Well, we'll miss you all. Enjoy your retirement. May we see those days too. I think that's all I can say right now. I'll pass the mic.
Come on, honey, you let it rip.
I wish you a happy retirement, enjoyment, fulfillment, and life just begins. And I can't wait till my begins. Do I have something to say?
No, I don't talk. I'm a man of few words, you know that.
Oh, yeah.
I have a few here for later.
Okay, great. Okay, say anything?
Oh, my God. Well, that's why I'm here today, Mrs. Daria, Geri, and all my old friends. I could see them today and happy, yeah.
Oh, I know.
Okay. Geri, Aida, I guess what? From the 70s and the 80s.
We wish you lots of luck.
Wish you lots of luck. This is a beautiful place, but they pale in comparison to both of you. I wish you all the best in retirement, and as good as you look, I don't know if you should retire. All right, take care.
Congratulations. We wouldn't miss this for the world. Aida, I will meet you every open school night, the way we agreed. And Geri, I'll never forget the A, E, I, O, U, if you remember what I'm saying. Bye.
Hi Aida, I'm glad you're retiring and you're going to rest, I hope. Thank you for teaching me how to be a teacher. Thank you. I love you.
Who would you like me to talk about first? Okay. Each retiree is really special. Aida fills so many different roles. She feeds us, she teaches, she's a master teacher, she's a mentor, and she's a fashion plate. So she will definitely be missed. Geri is so passionate about her teaching. She will definitely be a loss to the profession at Roosevelt. And I will miss the conversations. I can't think. All I can say is good luck and many happy years more to both of them.
Okay, go.
I would like to say thank you, Aida. Thank you, Geri, for all the help you gave me throughout all these years, all the butter that I gave you. Thank you very much, and I wish you the best of the luck and enjoy your life.
I'm not good at that. Okay, that's all I know how to say. Well, this is a beautiful club. It's a beautiful dinner. Nice to see old friends, old cohorts. It's a great day, and Miss Jady and Miss Tepper are so lucky. I have a time here to celebrate their great day. With or without
Hi, everybody. I'm glad to be here. I'm Jessie Matei, and it's wonderful to see everyone and to wish everybody well in their new life outside of Roosevelt. And I know they're going to enjoy it. Thanks.
Would anyone like to say anything?
Hi. Can you want some water?
Mike, you
want to
say anything?
Sure. How are you? Aida, I don't know what to say. You came to mine last year, and as soon as I finished mine, I wanted to come to yours. It's been a long year, but it's been a pleasure knowing you. Thank you, especially for being such a cheerful, vivacious person. Adios. Shalom. Auf Wiedersehen.
Tepper, I love you. Thank you for all the good advice you always gave me. I will remember you always. Very organized lady. The first lady I ever knew who organized herself so much to do grocery shopping. I will never forget that. Ms. Dayton, I love you. Thank you for all the delicious food you always brought to our department. I love you and thank you for all the good advice. Bye-bye.
Yes. Okay. So, Geri and Aida, enjoy your life and just take it easy and don't work too hard. Bye-bye. Pedro.
Would anyone like to say anything?
Represent the department, Mr. Hong. Mr. Hong,
you
represent
the
department.
Mr. Hong,
Mr.
Hong,
say.
What? Hey, we're both getting lost. I have a line for you. Now is the time to laugh and be merry. The work is all done for Aida and Geri. No more working or sweating, being ruled like a slob. The worst of it all, there's no comp time job. Let's all be more joyous and merry. No more attendance to go down to Geri. No more waiting in line. Your heart skips a throb. Her and that lousy comp time job. Aida is smiling, taking it with great zest. Ask her a question, she'll answer. Oh, yes, yes. Hey, Tink will watch with the air of a snob, then burst out in tears. I want that comp time job. Well, let's face it, folks. They spent many a year toiling at Roosevelt, thinking heaven was near. Aida was struggling against ignorance and deviance, while Geri was filing a continuance grievance. They are both full of memories they just want to shout. The best one, of course, was when Haywood got the hell out. I see Haywood is here to contribute his gas. If I knew he was coming, I would have really nailed his ass. It's nice that you came to honor these women, although possibly opposite on the sanity spectrum. They laugh, damn it. They both leave a legacy of exceptional teaching. One by cooing, the other by clutching. What matter does it make? They've done the job well. Their friends all love them and think they are swell. Geri runs through the halls with that officious whip. She runs through the calf with her tuna fish. Aida is working, her back is breaking, entering grades while doing her baking. Sometimes she screams, wants to commit Harry Carey, but instead goes with Jack on a wild safari. Geri to Florida to a new house will go to clean all those windows with large custom wipers. Aida has plans to change large dirty diapers. But whatever they do, wherever they go, if it's the last thing I do, I want them to know. They've done a wonderful job, so much sweat they have spilled. The void that they leave will never be filled. I've spent half of my life with these wonderful two. They're the best of professionals. They're tried and true. All will mellow in just a few more days, and life will take us down our separate ways. I, for one, will stop to reflect how time after time they've earned my respect. I don't like goodbyes. They seem final and cold. The French say it better, both women and men. Au revoir, au revoir, till we meet again. Geri and Aida, we love you, God bless you, and give you long life to follow your dreams.
Thank you.
Oh,
know that these two ladies are very, very special. We shared more than 25 years together. I know Geri's been like, what, 31? 31 and Aida?
25.
Yeah, 25 at Roseville. So we've kind of grown better together. I wouldn't say old, but we've grown better. Right, it's like a good wine. We've gotten better with age. And as I said, we've shared a lot. Happiness, sadness. Geri and I were pregnant at the same time, 77. So. Not the same time. It wasn't morbid. Okay. And Aida and I, we spoke about our daughters, graduation, those teenage years. You know, we struggled through those years. We shared birth. We shared graduations, we shared marriage ceremonies, everything that happens throughout 25 years. The good things and the bad things and the sadness. And we can never forget Mr. Martinez, those of you who have been here for a long time. John Kirby, Frank Petty, those of you who go back many years. I hear, all of you are responding, so they'll be gone, but as you can see, we'll come back. There's John Hayward, who left in 88. John, will you stand up? Some people say, who's John Hayward? John? John? Barbara?
Norma?
I mean, the one thing I think that distinguishes the language department is that it's like a big, happy family. You may leave, but we still remember you. I'm still in touch with Paquita Colon. Those of you who remember Paquita. Aida, back in the 70s. Tony Arcia, Rita Namenworth, Vivian Riconda. They all sent, they couldn't meet here, but they do remember. I remember Geri, Aida. And being here, I don't want to say goodbye. It's like hasta luego, because they'll be back. We'll hear from them. I'm part of them, they're part of me. It's like my life is entwined with theirs. My children used to share at the pool with Geri, that's Shore Haven. So yeah, I don't want to say anymore. The fact that all of you are here speaks for itself.
Yes.
So with all my love, my friends, my colleagues, mis amigas, adios. Now, on behalf of our language department, bilingual program, we have these flags for them. And they each read, Aida Davian, ESL teacher, in recognition of your many years. Okay, recognition of the many years of concern, dedication, and commitment to the students of the bilingual ESL program in Roseville High School, June 2001. And Geri, and I want you to know that besides being teachers in the department, these ladies held other positions. Geri was the attendance teacher for 18 years? Come time, okay. 12 years. Aida was the ESL coordinator. And we're still struggling to get those positions back. So guys, when you go back, okay, let's vote. Yes, okay. Let's get those positions back, we need them. Geraldine Tepper, Spanish and ESL teacher, in recognition of your many years of concern, dedication, and commitment to the students of the bilingual ESL program. Roseville High School, June 2001. And let me tell you, those lab kids are really going to miss Geri. We are going to miss Geri. She would always come in and she would talk about, oh, my lab babies. She's so concerned. And let me tell you, these two teachers, I mean, they did more than teaching. They share with the students. Thanksgiving, we walked into Jerry's class and she will be having a Thanksgiving, dinner. the Wednesday before Thanksgiving. She'll be bringing ice cream,
pie a la mo.
She'll bring food. Aida was an international fest. She's talking about baklava, spinach pie, kibbe. I mean, this went on practically every week. And I think, you know, part of my whatever pounds I gain, I owe them all to Aida's cooking. I think I'm going to lose weight. She's retiring, hopefully. Okay, so Geri, here you are. Okay? And my love goes out to you. And I want you to know that Jessica Newell sends her love. I spoke to her. Two members of the department went to see her. She's doing well. And let's just keep praying. And we hope she'll be there in September, because we really need her, at least I need her. Okay? I love you all. Thank you for being here. I'm not used to making big speeches. I have a lot to say when I'm angry, but when I'm really very, very happy, I really can't find very much to say. I'm overwhelmed tonight. It is one of the finest and most exciting days of my life. My heart is filled with happiness that so many of you felt so much love, and it honors me that you're all here to say goodbye to me. And I truly, truly will miss all of you. I miss the school, and I will miss my job. But life goes on. As I said to one of the teachers about 3 weeks ago, I'm in this building 31 years, and I have watched people come and go, just like a grandma letting her children go. And now I, the grandma, is finally leaving, but I see all my children coming back to say goodbye. And it really, really fills my heart that all of you think so much of me to come and say goodbye to me. Thank you all for coming.
That, you know, coming, yes, and Geri is a survivor, not just because she retired, but in a system as large as New York City, people get stepped on left and right, passed over, abused, etc., etc. So never Geri. That's the little line about the grievance. But the truth is, when going looks tough, remember this to it. Geri Tedder to oh shit.
Well, I've been so nervous about this whole thing to give the speech. I just want to thank everybody for being here today to honor this speaking occasion, especially Mirella and Marilena who did their best to give us this party. I thank you so much. And like Geri said, I'm going to remember, I take with me many memories of all of you. Last night I sat and I wrote a couple of things I cannot even read it down. But I love you all and thank you guys.